Welcome to Dental and Ayurveda, our channel for basic dental and basic Ayurvedic sciences. Our today's chapter is Transplantation and Tumor Immunity. Before beginning the chapter, I would like to thank you all for your support as we have just crossed 100 plus subscribers. Also, इस चैप्टर के रेडी टू रीड नोट्स अवेलेबल है हमारे इंस्टाग्राम पेज पे जिसका लिंक गिवन है डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में।
सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज ट्रांसप्लांटेशन एंड ट्यूमर इम्यूनिटी। सो ट्रांसप्लांटेशन इज अ वेरी यूजफुल प्रोसीजर फॉर रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ एनी डिजीज्ड और डिजीज्ड टिश्यूज और ऑर्गन्स व्हिच कैन नॉट बी रिपेयर्ड अगेन। सो द टिश्यूज और ऑर्गन्स ट्रांसप्लांट इट इज नोन एज इम्प्लांट और ग्राफ्ट। So like transplants, they survive only when the tissue or organ, it is taken up from the recipient himself, while grafts from any other individual of the same species or from a different species, that would be rejected. So what is the reason behind this rejection? What is the reason? The reason behind this rejection is the immune response induced by the transplantation antigens. So you can see that there are transplantation antigens which are going to induce an immune response, and that immune response is reason for the rejection. What are the types of transplant? The first type is autograft. So tissue or organ that is taken up from one site and engrafted to another site in the same individual. So this is happening in a same individual. Then isograft, it is taken from an individual and placed on another individual of the same genetic constitution. So that example, any grafts made between identical twins, this is isograft. Then allograft. So formerly it was also known as homograft. Now it is a graft transfer between two genetically non-identical members of the same species. So species are same, but they are genetically non-identical. Then xenograft, it is that the graft is between the members of different species. Then autografts and isografts, they are usually accepted, while allografts and xenografts, these are rejected due to genetic and antigenic incompatibility, because it is occurring between the different species. So the allograft reaction, let's talk about this. So rejection of the graft by the recipient is called the allograft reaction. The graft becomes vascularized during the first 2 or 3 days and appears to be accepted initially. It looks like it is accepted initially, but then by the 4th day, the inflammation, you can see the inflammation there, and the graft is invaded by lymphocytes and macrophages. So vascularity diminishes and due to the thrombosis, and graft undergoes ischemia, necrosis. So by the 10th day the graft sloughs off, these events resulting in the rejection of allograft. So that's why the allograft is rejected, is known as the first set response. Then cell mediated reaction is responsible for this reaction. Then, you know, when a second allograft from the same donor, if you take, like, is applied on a sensitized recipient. What do you mean by sensitized recipient? Like, in which the previous graft has been rejected by the first set response. So that will be again rejected in an accelerated fashion. So then the necrosis starts, and the grafts again by the 6th day, the graft sloughs off. So this is second set response. And in this, antibodies play important role along with the cell mediated immunity. Then we talk about histocompatibility antigens. So these are specific for each individual, and when the recipient possesses all the antigens present in the graft, there will be no immune response and the transplantation becomes successful. So major histocompatibility complex is a system of cell antigens that are responsible for allograft rejection or acceptance. So iska rejection hoga ya acceptance, this depends on the major histocompatibility complex. So in man, this complex is the human leukocyte antigen system. Then histocompatibility testing procedures used for, you know, matching the donor and the recipient that we do during the transplantation, that is ABO grouping first. It is very essential in all the tissues transplantations, because blood grouping antigens are along the histocompatibility antigens. Then hum tissue typing karte hain, we detect, you know, the MHC antigens. So the HLA antigen of class 1 type on leukocytes are identified by the means of anti-sera, which is obtained from multiparous women. So from the persons have received like multiple blood transfusions from individuals who are repeatedly, you know, skin grated. Then graft versus host reaction kya hoti hai? That graft rejection jo hota hai is generally due to reaction of the host to the grafted tissue. So the graft may mount an immune response against the antigen of the host, and this is known as graft versus host reaction. And this reaction is going to occur when the under the following conditions. Like what all conditions are there? Like the graft contains immunocompetent this T lymphocytes and MHC antigens of recipient activate, you know, then you can see that in immunocompetent T lymphocytes which produce lymphokines also and antibodies etc. So they are going to attack the recipient cells, leading to manifestations of GVH reaction. Then you can see that the recipient possess HLA antigen that are absent in the graft, and the recipient immunological responsiveness is either destroyed or it is impaired, that he cannot reject the graft. Now what are the manifestations of GVH reaction? So these are splenomegaly, fever, rashes, or sometimes, you know, death can also occur. Weight loss is the one more thing. Then we talk about the tumor immunity. So when a cell undergoes any malignant transformation hota hai uska, so it shows a new surface antigens which are immunologically distinct from the normal cells. So it different hota hai normal cells se, and ye kuch normal cells ko lose bhi kar deta hai. So the host recognizes the tumor associated antigens. Tumor can be considered as an allograft and is exposed to induce an immune response. So this is exposed to induce an immune response. Then we talk about the tumor antigens. So these are classified in two groups. First is your tumor specific antigens. So ye kaun se hote hain? That tumor specific antigens, they are present on the membrane of cancer cells. Cancer cells ki membrane pe present hote hain and normal cells mein nahi hote hain. So they induce an immune response when the tumor is transplanted. Okay, in animals, such tumor specific antigens, they reject the tumor transplants. In immunized hosts, these are termed as tumor specific transplantation antigens. Then tumor associated antigens, second, these are ye tumor cells mein present hote hain and normal cells mein bhi present hote hain. So these are going to include, first is the tumor associated carbohydrate antigens. So ye represent karte hain abnormal forms, glycoproteins and glycolipids, such as mucin associated antigen detected in pancreatic and breast cancers mein. And the second one is oncofetal antigens. So these are fetal antigens which are present in embryonic and malignant cells but not in the normal adult cells. Then example can be alpha fetoprotein in hepatomas, and you can see that carcinoembryonic antigen in colonic cancers also. Then differentiation antigens, you can see that antigen expressed in early B lymphocytes and is present in B cell leukemias as well. Similarly, prostate specific antigen is used as a ek diagnostic indicator ki tarah hum ise use karte hain prostate cancer. Then immune response in malignancy kaise hota hai, that both cell mediated and humoral responses, they are demonstrated in malignancy. The sensitized T cells, they are going to attack the foreign tumor cells and uski growth ko wo kam kar dega. So delayed type hypersensitivity, that type 4 hypersensitivity that we have learned in the previous video as well. So these play important role in tumor killing by releasing the lymphokines. So natural killer cells, NK cells means natural killer cells, they may provide the first line of defense against many tumors by killing the tumor cells in absence of antibody. Then we have immunosurveillance. So malignant cells jo hote hain, they are going to arise by frequent mutation of somatic cells. Jab somatic cells ka frequent mutation hota hai, to usse malignant cells bante hain. So our immune system, you know, it regularly keeps a check on this and it is going to destroy such malignant cells on the spot. okay, such somatic cells which are showing frequent mutation. Then inefficiency of the immune surveillance is the aging se ho sakta hai, and this may lead to chances of cancer, more chances of cancer.
Thank you for watching. Do like, share and subscribe if you like the video. And let us know ki aur kaun kaun se aise topics hain jin pe hum video bana sakte hain which you need to learn.